The Gnarwoods are fleshy mutated trees that twist themselves around ancient structures and force warbands into their bamboo and bone constructs. Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint one of the rib platforms from the Warcry Heart of Gur box set up to battle ready. Now, before we begin, we need to give our scenery here an undercoat, and as you can see, I have used Xandri dust. So we'll be starting off with a few base coats. I'll be using Mournfang Brown for the dirt, and then Gorthor Brown and Baneblade Brown for the tree. So let's get on with that dirt. So I'm going to just dip into the pot. I'm going to just thin it down slightly because we need a small amount of it on our base brush here, and then we can start applying it to our scenery. So the dirt is just all the way around here, so I'm just going to avoid any of the bamboo or bone. But don't worry if we do, we can always tidy it up later. With the dirt now painted, we're going to move on to painting the body of the tree with Gorthor Brown. We want to cover the whole tree with this as well, and you may need a couple of coats. Now that's dry, we can move on to the Baneblade Brown. And what we're going to do with this is we're going to apply it to the ends of the branches, one of these weird finger looking things. And what we're going to do is we're going to slowly drag up the paintbrush with the remainder of the paint. And what this does is it allows it to blend softly with the rest of the branch, giving you a nice easy blend. With our first base coats dry, we can move on to our last base coats. We'll be starting off with Mechanicus Standard Grey for our grey details, Wraithbone for our bone details, and using Xandri dust just to tidy up for the bamboo. So let's start with that Mechanicus Standard Grey. So like before, we're going to just dip into the pot. I'm going to thin it down slightly. I'm going to use this small brush just to get into any small nooks and crannies. So let's get started. So we've got loads of little stones all around the base, so we're just going to fill all those in. You can also use this colour for any of the straps around the bamboo structure. With that dry, now we can move on to the Wraithbone, and we're going to use that all over the bone areas, the teeth, any horns that are laying out on the ground, and the claws on the tree. You may need a couple of coats of this just to get a nice coverage. With the Wraithbone now dry, we can use Xandri dust, and we're going to use this just to touch up any areas that have other colours on the bamboo. Now that our base coats are now dry, we can move on to the shades. We'll be starting off with Targor Rage Shade for the main body of the tree, and then Berserker Blood Shade for the fingers of the tree. So let's get started. So we're going to just dip into the pot, but we don't need too much. We're using a large shade brush for this, and then we can start applying it to the tree. So we're going to coat all over the tree, just with a nice thin layer, avoiding the fingers of the tree and those claws as well. Don't worry if it pulls in areas, you can always pull it around or soak it off with a clean brush. Now that the Targor Rage shade is dry, we're going to apply another layer just towards the bottom of the roots up to the trunk, just to give a darker sheen. Now that second layer is now dry, we can move on to the Berserker Blood shade. I'm going to apply this over the fingertips of the tree. We're going to slowly drag it up as well into those recesses towards the branches. With those shades now dry, we can move on to our last shade and contrast. We'll be starting off with Agrax Earthshade thinned down with contrast medium for the bone and grey details, and Agaros Dunes thinned down with contrast medium for the bamboo. So let's start with the Agrax Earthshade. So what we're going to do is take three parts of contrast medium. I'm going to pop it onto our palette here, two and three. And then we're going to give our brush a little clean in the water and dry it off on some paper. And I'm going to take one part Agrax Earthshade and we're going to thin it down. So we just want to mix that really well. I'm going to make sure our brush is slightly pointy and we don't take too much of the contrast. There we go. And our shade is ready to go onto those details. So we're going to apply it all over the bone. Any of those grey details like the rocks and any of those straps around the bamboo construct. And now that's dry, we can move on to agarose dunes, and we're going to thin that down with one part contrast medium, just to thin it down slightly, just for the bamboo. You may find that you want another coat just to go into those recesses of the bamboo. And now that our shades and contrasts are dry, our brick platform is now complete. And there you have it. Our Warcry Hartiger scenery is now battle ready to destroy and consume any unfortunate fighters who wander too close. By following these methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily apply this to any terrain in your collection. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own Warcry Hartiger box set, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye!